Good morning, good afternoon, or good evening, wherever you are in the world. My name is James Flores, and welcome to another online organ recital on my Hauptwerk installation at home in my music room. The sample set I'll be using for this recital is provided by Sonus Paradisi, and it's the Oakland Aeolian Skinner sample set. So it's an American instrument over three manuals, and I decided to use this instrument because it's probably what a lot of American parish churches would have at their disposal. So I thought, why not provide a recital on something that sounds very familiar and can cope with a lot of the organ repertoire we play today. The first piece that you just heard was a little piece by Lebesgue, a French classical composer. So not the right instrument, but I think it still does a reasonably good job in pulling the colours and sounds of it. Thank you for joining this premiere of my recital. You'll notice I'll be talking to you in the live chat. I've also enabled Super Chat and stickers in this premiere. You can add custom emojis or highlighted messages. So if you do feel like doing it, please go ahead, and I really thank you for your support. The next piece on our program today, so the first quarter of the program is kind of focused on Advent and Christmas stuff, because we're coming up to that right now. So we've got In Dulce Jubilo, BWV 729 by Bach, a little chorale on Vom Himmelhoch by Pachelbel, and the Wacket Auf by Bach, the 645, the trio. So I'll just play them all through and we'll talk about it afterwards.
Thank you.
Well, I got myself out of a little tricky spots there. I just lost some concentration, and that's what happens. Sometimes just can't avoid it. Well, you can avoid it with more practice, but I just, I guess I went off daydreaming, and it kind of scared me a little bit, but we got there in the end. And I hope you noticed the Zimbelstern in the Pachelbel there. And I use one of the pistons here to switch it off at exactly the same time I finished the note and started the piece. And of course we had the organo plano in the In Dulce Jubilo. So now we'll move on to another piece of Bach, the Prelude and Fugue in C major, BWV 531. And this is a quick addition into my recital program. It wasn't originally planned, but Vidas challenged me to learn this in 2 weeks. So seeing as though I already learnt it, I put it into this program today. So we'll play the Prelude and Fugue in C major, BWV 531 by Bach, and we'll discuss how it went afterwards. And it's going to be a different performance because I'm playing it again, and it's on a totally different organ. So the first time I performed this, it was on the Rotterdam organ. You can hear that on my channel. And of course, we've got this Aeolian Skinner organ. So hope you'll be able to appreciate the difference.
Thank you.
That was Bach's Prelude and Fugue in C major, BWV 531. And I think that registration worked quite well. Let me know what you think. That's the brightest I could get the organ without using the super octave couplers. And I want to avoid them because you might run off the end of the rank there and you lose some of the counterpoint. So next on the program is a suite by my organist friend Phil Lanebauer, and over the past year, I suppose I've featured a lot of his music on my channel because I do like his compositional style. And this is a Mighty Fortress suite. It is obviously based on the hymn tune Ein Festiberg, and it's in three movements. We have a fanfare, a meditation, and a, what's the last one, is called a march. So I'll play through this three movement suite and we'll talk about how it went afterwards.
Thank you.
That was Phil Lanebauer's A Mighty Fortress Suite. And the last page of that sounded a bit like Super Mario Brothers. Well, that's what it sounded like to me, but it was just those chromatic modulations and harmonies. Very, very great stuff. I think we're down to the last item in our program. Let me double check. Yes, we are. I'll now finish, unfortunately, finish today's recital with a piece by Denny Bedard, another modern composer. And this is his variations on In Dulci Jubilo. So we're ending with another Christmas piece. And it gives me a chance to show off again the different colours of this organ. And come to think of it, when I was playing that last piece by Phil, I thought to myself, has anyone actually done a recital on this Hauptwerk sample set before? And because I pretty much searched the entire YouTube over my lifetime looking at all these organ videos, I haven't come across it in recital. So perhaps I'm the first one to give a recital on the Aeolian Skinner sample set by Stanis Paradisi. In that case, you are very lucky. All right, enough talking. I will finish off with this piece and we'll discuss it afterwards.
Thank you.
That was Danny Bedard's Variations sur In Dulce Jubilo. And what a fantastic grand ending on full organ there. I do use a little bit of reverb in this sample set because it is quite dry, but I don't go over the top because I suspect the church that it's in doesn't have the same reverberation as, say, St. Lawrence Kirk Rotterdam organ there. So it's very hard to play cleanly and sound okay on this organ because it's very exposed, can't hide behind reverb. And in the adagio movement there, I kind of just lost track of where I was going and slipped on the solo, which was unfortunate, but these things happen and I hope you can forgive me for that. And that concludes today's recital, and I'm unsure if this is my last recital for the year, but we'll see what happens. But I'll always be quite active on my channel and posting little videos here and there, so please subscribe, please give a big thumbs up to this video, and thank you to those of you, if you have, used the Super Chat feature in today's premiere. Also, before I go, see this, there it is, Swellvox merchandise. If you've been following my channel, a group of us lads make music together quite often, and we're called Swellvox, and if you'd like to support us, please buy our merch. I'll leave a link in the description below. All right, enough of that, and I'll catch you in my next video. Bye for now.